With all the forums, groups, and video tutorials online, do you need a PowerDirector manual in 2022? I'm going to share my thoughts, compare a few resources, and hook you up with a valuable tool that'll be a lifesaver to a bunch of PowerDirector users. The links to any resources I discuss will be in the video description. First, let's compare forums and manuals. Forums and users groups are great places to meet people with similar interests. The PowerDirector Users Group and the PowerDirector Forum are two of the leading resources or sites for PowerDirector. You can ask questions, get tips, ideas, tricks, and all types of responses from other users of the program. If you're having technical issues, you can share your files, share screenshots of the issue that you're having, or even share your PC diagnostics with other users of the group to help facilitate fixing your problem. One of the downsides to a forum is that you have to wait for someone to respond to your question when you start a new thread. This isn't really conducive to those in time-sensitive situations, but if you can wait a while, it might be okay. If you have a manual, based on the complexity of your query, you can usually find the information right away. Browsing a table of contents or the index will usually get you right to where you need to go. When I need a manual, I turn to the moviepix.com guide to PowerDirector. I'll leave a link in the video description if you want to pick up a copy and support the channel. In my humble opinion, if you need support for a technical issue, a forum or a group is your best bet. If you need instruction or direction on how to use the program, then you'll find the answer quicker using a manual. Now let's talk a little bit about tutorials and manuals. Video tutorials are a great way to receive step-by-step instructions on how to use PowerDirector. There are literally thousands of PowerDirector tutorials focusing on a wide range of subjects. They're great for figuring out complex edits, special effects, and learning new skills. You can check out a bunch of dope special effects tutorials that I made right here. Unfortunately, the quality, content, and instruction of tutorials varies widely from channel to channel. Video tutorials can be too fast, too slow, or they just don't share enough information to help the user fully understand the process. When you have a manual, you receive step-by-step instructions that are simple to understand. There are static images with callouts which provide additional information that many tutorials don't provide. You can bookmark sections of a manual and go back and read them whenever you want without having to rewind. Unlike video tutorials, where you have to save a video to a playlist, go back and find that video, and then find the place in that video that you're looking for. If you're looking to make complex edits or special effects, tutorials are probably the way to go. If you need more robust, consistent instruction, and you regularly need to retrieve information, you should probably pick up a manual to supplement the video tutorials that you watch. So, do you really need a PowerDirector manual in 2022? The answer to that is up to you. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section. Earlier in the video, I mentioned some forums and groups for PowerDirector users. If you want to know the places I go when I need help using PowerDirector, check out this video. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.